Hello, how's everyone tonight? Hello, hello. How's everybody doing tonight? Let me know if you hear me correctly. Last time you had a little hard time with the sound itself. Do it like this if the sound is good. Good, thank you, yes it is. How's everyone tonight? I hope everybody's doing well. Just to guys, for you to know, I was in the Dominican Republic last week, just for a couple of hours. And I had to tell you that the airport was a little bit, I would say it wasn't that crazy. It was more news than anything else. You do need to go in with your COVID exam. There's no question about it. You need to have your COVID test. If you don't have your COVID test, you have to make a line for you to get COVID tested. Solo para que sepan, yo estuve en República Dominicana hace unos días por unas horas. Y le puedo decir que el aeropuerto estaba, no estaba realmente tan loco como se comenta. Creo que es más propaganda que otra cosa. Lo que sí le puedo decir es que necesitan ir con su prueba de COVID. No puede llegar al país sin la prueba de COVID. Muy, pero muy importante. La prueba del COVID. Y si no tiene la prueba del COVID, empresa, tiene que tener empresa, necesitan hacerse su prueba en el mismo aeropuerto. No se los recomiendo porque las líneas pueden ser bastante, bastante largas. Bueno, es un placer para mí estar con todos ustedes esta noche. Veo que mi hermana está por ahí. Veo a la doctora Natalia también que está por ahí. Un abrazo, doctora. Y sí, lo único que les puedo decir a todos es que por favor se cuiden mucho en el transcurso de llegar al país y que vayan con sus pruebas. La salud primero antes de la belleza. I would like to make sure all of you know and all of you take as much precautions as you can. And please bring in with you your COVID test because right now it's essential that you go in with the test when you get to the actual country. If not, you need to make a line and I'm going to keep stressing it. Your health is first before the beauty itself. Bueno, hoy vamos a estar platicando con una muñeca del doctor Flores, Ashley. Vamos a ver si Ashley está por acá. Y si está por acá, mírala acá, vamos a conectarnos con... ¿Quieren escribir sus preguntas? Y vamos a ver si hacemos esta entrevista en inglés. Voy a tratar. Creo que no será problema. Hello, hello.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Oh, perfect. You speak English. That's awesome.
Yes, I do.
They want to kill me here with all these Latinas and no English around. Like, ah.
Yeah. I do.
¿Cómo estás? ¿Bien?
Todo bien, gracias a Dios. ¿Y tú?
Amén. Gracias al Señor. Muy bien. Vamos a hacer esto en Spanglish. We both speak both languages. That's
awesome. Era contigo que yo estaba hablando en WhatsApp, ¿no?
Era conmigo, que no, tú estás hablando conmigo, estás hablando con mi asistente, pero aquí estoy.
Ah, ok.
Bueno, cuéntanos de ti, Ashley, cuéntanos un poco de ti.
Sobre la cirugía.
Claro, bueno, sobre ti en sí, cuéntanos quién eres, a qué te dedicas. Sé por mis propias fuentes por ahí que eres una excelente makeup artist.
Oh, yes, I am.
I know that, so I had to come see you so you can, I actually don't like makeup too much. So I do need to come see you so you can give me a little bit of touch-ups here and there.
Yo antes yo me ponía 3 libras de maquillaje, pero ya I'm more to like the simple side.
This is the most you're ever going to see me with.
Yeah.
It took me 4 minutes.
That's about what I do.
And if you can, let's try to maintain it in English a little bit more, just because I know a lot of people are a little bit aggravated with me because I just keep doing Spanish interviews lately.
Okay. Well, what can I say? Lo primero es que it was pure coincidence that I went to Flores because when I was here, I was researching whatever, I wanted to do my body from the get with Cabral. So I do my appointments, whatever, I have my day set. I get to DR, I do my analysis. He sees the analysis, he says everything was great, I was good to go. Come back tomorrow at 6 a.m., no water, no foods. Perfect, understandable. So I get there at 6 in the morning. I had to do the other test for your lungs.
Mm-hmm.
I did that. Then he sees the analysis and he sees that. He says everything is good. We're all set to go to do my body at 10 p.m. Mind you, I was already there at 6 a.m. I was super hungry. I was super thirsty. And I think it was just mentally because I knew I couldn't drink or eat. So
You were
they.
more hungry.
Exactly. I have never been more hungry in my life than that day. So whatever. He's like, "Oh, you're all set to go for 10 p.m." I'm like, "No way." I mean, I'm super hungry. I'm getting mad already. I'm in a bad mood. There's no way that he's gonna come in at 7 in the morning. He takes his first patients at 7 in the morning and still 10 p.m. he's still operating. So I'm like, "No. I'll leave it for tomorrow. I'm coming back tomorrow."
Okay.
Okay, whatever. The person that took my turn, she passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't know her, but being that that girl passed away, he couldn't work the next day. So I still went. I didn't know he couldn't work. So yo llegué allá al otro día operarme con Cabral, because that's who I wanted to do my body with.
Yeah,
Pero
he's an outstanding doctor, really.
unfortunately, because of that girl passing away, he couldn't work the next day. So I went and I did a consultation with Rodriguez. I did consultation
With a couple of doctors there.
with a couple.
Okay.
And then I went to Flores, and the second I walked in, his girls working in the office, his nurse, him himself, everything was like, mind you, I didn't do, call me crazy, I didn't do no research on him at all, because that's how bad I wanted to get my body done. And he was already there and I felt good, whatever. So I'm like, you know what, que sea lo que Dios quiera. So él me dio mi cita. He read my analysis and he's like, "I can't operate you like this. I guess there was something wrong. Yo no sé si era la plaqueta roja o algo pasaba." He's like, "I can't." So me puso en tratamiento por una semana and then he operated me. Pero Cabral me iba a operar así.
Pero tell me you end up eating. You had
Huh?
some food. You had some food on that day, right?
Oh,
'Cause you
yeah,
were starving and you were
definitely.
like
Definitely, definitely, I did. Pero lo que te. Lo que.
Your exams were something was off. You're not 100%
Yes.
on what it was, and then he sent you for you to get some tests done,
Yes.
and a treatment for a week.
He put me on treatments and
Was it
then.
a hemo treatment
What do you mean?
for
Yeah,
you to
so.
increase your hemoglobin para subir tu nivel de la sangre o
Maybe.
fue más como?
I think so. I don't remember exactly porque ya hace almost 2 years.
Wow.
Yeah, but it was, ¿cómo te digo? Cabral, like I said, Cabral me iba a operar así. He said everything was good. The second he seen the analysis, he's like, "I can't operate you like this."
Bueno, sabes, todos los doctores tienen su manera. Every doctor have their own way of doing things. And personally, I understand that I personally love a lot of them, the one that actually do and care for our girls, for us, right? As
Of
dolls
course.
itself, everybody have their pros, everybody have their cons. Y lo primero que yo digo es research. You have to research and feel comfortable who you go with. You made a nice point. You just mentioned right now. Hey, yo no he hecho ningún tipo de research with him, but you still feel comfortable because he was hands-on. And Flores' team tends to be hands-on. That is true. No todos los doctores hacen eso. No todos los doctores son hands-on. Hay muchas veces que tú nunca llegas a ver a un doctor hasta que te operan.
Hasta que, yeah.
O 1 hora antes, o 2 horas
Yeah.
antes. Siempre son las secretarias. So, eso es una
Bueno,
diferencia ahí.
déjame decirte que cuando yo me operé, aparte de que ya yo me había puesto en tratamiento una semana antes, yo me operé y a mí me bajó la hemoglobina a 5.
Wow.
Yeah, en 5. You know it's supposed to be like 13 something. So yo era una muerta en vida, literally. Luckily, I didn't have to get no me tuvieron que poner sangre, pero the doctor was with me all step of the way. That's one thing I can say. Él tiene una enfermera allá que se llama María. Él me la
Nadia.
mandó every day. She was in my house. He used to call me te hicieron los jugos, te tomaste tu medicamento, las inyecciones, every step of the way he was there. Que si lo masaje, todo, 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 todo. De ese doctor no me puedo quejar.
Y sabes, Ashley, ese es un punto muy delicado, porque no todos los doctores están al punto de mantener esa consistencia. You know, not everyone is so consistent. Just for you girls, I know there's a mix of people here, Spanish and English, where they actually get to speak to the doctor. There's a lot of girls actually out there that they want a consultation, a virtual consultation. De pronto dicen, quiero una consulta virtual, pero realmente es imposible porque sabes que hay tantas pacientes, pero hay doctores que son diferentes, hay doctores que toman el caso bien personal y yo entiendo eso ahora mismo del doctor Flores.
In my case, he basically took it casi personal because he used to call me. Te hicieron el jugo, te bebiste el jugo, te tomaste la pastilla, o sea, todo. Y yo estaba tan como tan mal que yo desde que me levanté en la recuperación, esa era llora, 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 llamando a todo el
Bendito.
mundo. Because yo me hice todo. I couldn't be laying down. Ni boca abajo, ni boca arriba, ni de lado. So I was like, ya yo estaba desesperada. Entonces, I felt so tired. I don't know. I wanted to die.
Let's talk about your procedures. What did you get done? I'm going to put up your picture because you look fantastic.
Thank you. I did breast reduction with implants. I did lipo all over and fat transfer, BBL.
How big were your breasts before your breast reduction?
They were pretty big. I'm a triple D now, but that's because I gained a little bit of weight. Cuando él me redujo like a double D maybe. I wanted them smaller. He's like, you shouldn't go smaller or whatever.
Well, then you look great, as we can see in the photo there. I mean,
Thank you.
he did a great job. I did
Yeah.
not have a before photo because you didn't share a before photo with us. Not everybody likes to show that before photo.
I don't mind because honestly, I had done a first round before I went to Florida, so I wasn't that bad. I
How
was just
many
a little
rounds you had so far?
two.
Two. Okay. And how do you
But
feel about plastic surgery? Go ahead.
I love it. Plastic surgery is like tattoo. When you go for the first tattoo, you're already thinking about going for the second tattoo and whatever. Honestly, yo no sé, it's like addictive. And I mean, why not?
¿Sabes qué, Ashley? Es una adicción. Es una adicción
If I can enhance
completamente.
my beauty somehow, then so be it.
Well, do you feel, how has it changed your life? How do you think it has changed you? Because I
Honestly,
see you very comfortable right now, which it
nah.
gets my attention. This is why. Most girls that I interview, they go crazy. They put makeup on. They do this. They do that. And I love your down look because sometimes I go
Oh
on just
yeah.
like normal myself. I actually put a show for 5 minutes, and then as soon as I turn this camera off, I'm taking everything off because I'm just not a makeup person.
I
And I
really
see
don't
your down
care.
look. So tell me how it has changed you. What it has given you? Has it given you more confidence? How do you
It
feel in general?
definitely has. Growing up, I have always had millions of compliments. Oh, que tú eres bella, que tú esto, que tú lo otro. Pero I never really felt that way. Yo no era gorda, yo no, nada. Pero que yo siempre decía que until I don't do my body, I'm not gonna be comfortable. I'm not gonna feel beautiful, whatever. Yes, me subió la autoestima a cierto punto que now, after I did my body, yo me siento como que, okay, now I feel like I really love myself. Before, I wouldn't even
It's
feel
okay.
comfortable under my own skin.
I
You
love
know?
what you are saying. You feel like you can love yourself.
Yeah.
And you know, I always say that feeling comfortable under your own skin, it's one of the most important thing there is in life. At the end of the day, how we feel internally is what's going to show in the outside.
Yo
And
me acomplejaba mucho. Es que, bueno, para las chicas que tenemos aquí en Latina, hablando español solamente, es tan pero tan importante sentirnos bien con nosotras mismas. No es solamente esa belleza, o mira qué cuerpazo tienes de pronto, pero entendemos que a muchas de nosotros nos cambia la vida porque nos hace sentir segura de nosotras mismas. Y de pronto esa seguridad se puede ver por arriba con la ropa más sencilla que tengas, una gorra, un sweatpants,
Mira cómo yo
una ropa
ando,
de
mira, mira.
ejercicio.
Always, this is me. Like, I feel so comfortable. Like, I don't care.
Great,
Y
great.
antes, before, I would feel like if I don't have 10 pounds of makeup, I can't go out, or I wouldn't let nobody see me like that. Oh my God, no. Ya
Do you
no,
have
it's
any
like,
kids?
no.
No, no kids yet.
Mm-mm.
I have a 2-year-old.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so as soon as you have yours, you might go, oh, you're a girl, whichever you get, a girl, a boy, you're gonna go back end up and
Oh
get your
yeah.
little fixes.
Oh.
Are you considering plastic surgery again?
Yes.
What are you getting done?
I want to reduce my boobs again.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't like, I feel like they're too big, and then it's like I get it from my family. No matter how many times I reduce them, I'm always gonna get them back unless I do the la glándula mamaria.
Ajá.
Que no, que eso es lo que hace que crezcan, right?
Correcto. Entonces, por ahí va el problema que tienes. You have like it's a family more than
Yeah.
anything else.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, do you know which doctor you're gonna go with, or you know, or you're still in your process of researching?
Honestly, I might go back to Flores, but I'm not sure.
Okay.
Or it's either Flores or Colombia.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, right now we are between both countries for a lot of girls. They always decide, but most of them always end up going to the Dominican Republic because of the quality of the
Yeah.
work that it comes out of it. Tell me, if you had to say two sentences about Dr. Flores, what would you say about him?
Two sentences. Yo
You know
diría
what?
que
Make it a paragraph if you want.
un doctor súper responsable and super committed. Like, he's committed to his clients. Like, he
Yes.
takes, I don't know if it's, I don't know, I'm not sure if he had a connection or what, but I felt like, como que yo lo conocía desde todo el tiempo.
Y esa es actually la parte de sentirnos cómodos.
Yeah,
De
because
sentir.
if si tú vas a donde un doctor y tú no te sientes conectada con ese doctor, tú no te sientes cómodo, how are you going to let that person operate you?
That's right. Right, because you being on the table is a big deal, and
Exactly.
it's a huge deal, and not everybody gets it. It's a big deal, and you need to be certain and comfortable who you go with.
Yeah.
I cannot stress that as much, more than that. A lot of girls tend to, personally, I feel it's a mistake. They tend to always look at, let's say they look at your body and they say, oh, I really want to look like her, and they don't understand that we have our own frames.
We
You
had.
got your frame, I have my own frame. And it doesn't mean because you go to a particular doctor, you're going to look just like that. It has a
Right.
lot to do with your research and trying to find a body that is similar to what you are looking for. I'm always
Right.
going to continue stressing that.
Mommy,
All day long.
That's right.
Bueno, chicas, para las latinas que tengo por allá, se estresa mucho el punto. Por ejemplo, miramos el cuerpo de Ashley, que está hermoso. Y de pronto queremos a las mujeres decir, bueno, yo me quiero ver así como ella se ve. Pero tenemos que entender que no es solamente vernos de esa manera. Cada uno tenemos nuestro propio cuerpo, nuestra propia manera, nuestra propia caja, como le digo yo. Y es importante que hagamos nuestros estudios, con qué doctor nos vamos y sentirnos cómodos con ese doctor. Todo el mundo tiene su experiencia, todo el mundo tiene su opinión. Yo puedo tener una experiencia maravillosa y no quiere decir que Ashley la tuvo igual que yo. So eso es muy, pero
Right.
muy importante, manejarse de esa manera. Ashley, we would love to see how you look right now in your I know you have some spandex right now on your
Yes.
hat. We would love to see
Wait.
how you look.
Hold on. I don't have, I guess I have to show you like this because I don't really have.
Oh, you look great. Look at that. Have you gained much weight after your surgery?
Yes, I did actually. You know, I put on some quarantine weight. Nothing too crazy, but I want to say maybe 10 pounds.
Do you work in a day to day? Do you work out?
Yeah, I'm working out now.
Okay. You're running, you're going, what are we
I'm
doing?
doing bite-sized cardio here and there in the gym. I go to
Okay.
the gym and work out.
Well, I'm ready to start running again. I haven't ran in maybe 5 weeks. I had a real tough summer.
It took me a lot to start, but I'm sorry.
It's
I was
okay.
saying it did take me a lot to start, but I started.
Well,
Qué es lo
I
importante.
que lo importante, claro que sí, there's no such thing as perfection, nada es perfecto en la vida. La clave es empezar y saber cuándo empezamos y mantener la consistencia, que la consistencia es lo que nos lleva a algo diferente. Ashley,
Right.
cuéntame, so when you're gonna get your breast done, please let me know. I would love to see your results.
I
I would
will.
love to see the real before at this point and the
All
after.
right, I will.
I'm gonna send you a message. I have a line of makeup artists right now on that we need to. We're actually gonna be doing a competition soon of some of girls. And you, where are you?
Yeah.
What state are you in?
I'm in Massachusetts right now.
Ah, what part?
Lawrence.
Lawrence. I lived in Fall River, right next to Lawrence.
And where?
Fall River, Massachusetts.
Okay.
Yeah, it's further up. It's not so far from you there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I look forward to see you soon, and thank
All
you so
right.
much for your time.
No problem. I'll be
Muchísimas
waiting for your
gracias.
message.
Claro que sí, yo te lo voy a mandar. Desde que termine
Bye.
todos estos lives, cuídate.
Okay,
Chao.
bye.
Bye bye. Okay, guys. So thank you so much for joining us. We have another interview right after this, with Dr. Richardo Stoll. Stay tuned. He also did a fantastic job. She looks great as well. I would like to thank you for spending some time with me today. I know it's Sunday. I know it was 6:30, and thankfully, we weren't scared right now. I had a crazy day. Muchas gracias a todos por estar conmigo hoy. Voy a tener una entrevista en unos 3 minutos con una muñeca del doctor Guichardo. Bye, cuídense y un abrazo a todas.